Hey guys, doing another boss guide today. It's going to be about Xy'mox, pretty in-depth. This is a fight that's pretty specific on how you need to deal with a few mechanics. It's not hard overall necessarily with any metric. It's just you need to do a few things right. There's one really hard wave, and then every class kind of needs to know how to deal with seeds. So in this video, I'm going to go over how you do every spirit set, at least the way that we do it, and I think the timers that most guilds get. Obviously positioning and stuff like that, but how every single popular class would deal with the seed that they're doing, and then how to make the very, very hardest part of the fight a lot easier. All right, so just to start, we're going to talk about offensive cooldown timing. So this fight in general, the only thing that matters for cooldowns is 60% to zero. And I'll kind of go over how that'll work. It doesn't affect most classes, but it does affect two of them if you want to be completely optimal for killing this. I will go ahead and tell you that my comp suggestion is actually to 5 heal, especially if this is a first kill, and I'll kind of show you why later with what's actually hard about the fight. It's pretty easy to look at it as just a, this part of the fight is just like, it's like, oh, you want to get through it as fast as possible because the end is hard. But in reality, having 4 healers doesn't allow you to beat anything that 5 healers does, right? It doesn't allow you to like skip a mechanic set. And the mechanic set that you could potentially skip is the easiest mechanic set they could have ever designed, so you don't need to skip it. You could RP walk it and do it in time. It's that easy. So I do recommend 5 healers because the seed dot will kill people. However, I wouldn't worry about it too much. Just you could do either. If you have 4 strong healers, 4 heal it. If not, I would highly suggest 5 healing. So for offensive cooldowns, get the first 2 set of seeds. I'll tell you, and I'll show you when we go through the boss video after I show you guys how to do spirits and seeds and stuff, exactly where you want to stop DPS. But you want to stop and wait for the second seeds to happen before 60%. And why that is for a really good lust burn. The lust burn right now is at the 3-minute mark. So you want to hold your second 2 minutes, not use them above 60%. You're going to stop DPS around 60 to 64% right after they come up anyway. So you hold those, you do the very first mechanic set under 60%. And then after you get back from those spirits, you just lust, and then 2 minutes are up, 3 minutes are up, so you have every cooldown, and you're also standing still for an entire minute. So it's like the perfect scenario for a lust. Now, if you have a lot of damage, you can beat the second set of seeds under 80%. In fact, in our main raid, we do. But if you're learning this fight, you're probably not, and I would encourage you not to, because it's going to make the last phase harder if people are using cooldowns on CD, so... that's how what I'd recommend for that. And as far as defensive cooldowns, obviously healing cooldowns, you just kind of want to spread those out. Just spirit shell on CD if you have a priest. As far as spirit links, AMZs, barriers, darkness, Devo, stuff like that, use those for tank explosions. Now, you can use it for general throughput because there are parts of the fight where you're just taking a ton of damage. But none of the things actually kill you in the fight. There's 2 things that kill you in this fight. It's tank mechanic plus something, or it's a seed person who has to run away far from the boss with the seed dot. So the withering touch plus having to do a seed, if you don't properly external that person before they leave, they can die. But yeah, that's basically it. Other than that, it's just the glyph of destruction combined with raid damage. So a good time to use CDs is just CDing every single glyph of destruction as a tank. The tank ability glyph of destruction. So just do that whenever you can. Other than that, it's pretty simple. All right, so we're going to talk about, we're going to get to seeds in a second, which you can already see I've planned out here. This is the general positioning, by the way. These are the main 5 seeds. Then here's the tears. Note that star is not exactly on the thing. You want it to be a little bit this way, and I'll show you that when we get to the seeds. But first, I want to show you guys the spirits. So I have a VOD here of myself doing this boss on a DK. I'm going to show you every spirit wave right now and exactly how to deal with it correctly as a raid leader. How you should raid lead and be prepared to do this. And I think raid leading really helps with spirits, so you can really remind people of when they're going in. So the very first set is easy. Comes out a few seconds from now. Okay, first set of spirits comes out. No one needs help on how to do this, right? Also, the reason why I picked this video just before going anything further, number one, I'm playing in it, and I don't want to hear from people like, oh, you know, like, well, I have to raid lead and play the game. Like, no, you can do both, obviously, right? On almost every fight. This, specifically, this group is super undergeared. I think this is 211 eye level. This is our worst raid. This is our last boss. Xy'mox is what we did. We did one shot it this week, which is nice. But it's just going to show you a few things on how to do spirits. All right, so first set of spirits is very simple. You just do it right now. There's nothing else happening. Don't need to talk about it. You just run between those things. The only reason we have the boss in the middle there, slight damage optimization, it's just so people can do damage while they're taking the thing, or at least ranged can. All right, so the first thing before we get into the first spirit, I do want to tell you about tears. You're going to hear me mention a few times in this video that there are fake tears. What fake tears means is if you get a set of tears right before you hit 80% or right before you hit 60%, you don't need to move them out. You can have them stay on the boss, because as soon as he goes into a new phase, he's going to cast a new set anyway before anything happens. So that's when you'll hear me call these are fake tears. These are fake tears. And as you'll see, this monk is going to stay on the boss instead of obviously moving to the correct spot. And someone accidentally took the gate too, which is pretty funny. All right, so here's the first set of spirits, or the first hard set of spirits, second total one of the fight. How you want to do it is you want to have the boss here on the other side of square. If you want to see it in raidplan.io, you have the boss right here. Okay? You have the boss like right here and the raid behind the boss. Very, very important, okay? Because if you're facing this way, your spirits are going to spawn back here behind you. And that's very important for this movement. This is actually maybe one of the hardest spirit sets of the actual fight. And you want to have some kind of a roar here. If you want to have two speed totems for later, you can't use a speed totem here. But if you do have a druid, this is a really good roar. As soon as you see the spirit marker, you move as a group. Okay? So you go in. Spirits happen. We get a clear here. I get a clear. You'll see tears come out. And then you see seeds come out. You don't move yet for the seeds. Now, keep in mind, the seed people are doing their own thing. This is just everyone else. You see the spirit spawn, and then you move. And the reason why is because you cannot take this terror early. You have to wait until the seeds actually blow up, which is why you bait and give yourself this much room. And then watch it come in. Look at the spirits. You can even see that I have a spirit here. Now, this is a little different because you're gonna see that the entire raid's about to die, so I have to do the typical take the seed in and just accept death to save everyone else maneuver. But these spirit people don't go into this tear here until these seeds explode, which is why you need to give yourself this much room. By the time these seeds blow up, these spirits will be really close to you too. So you just wanna give yourself as much room as possible on this set for spirits. I'll show my hero play just for fun. Wow, that was actually even closer than I thought. Literally, wow. Okay, well, and then the next set of seeds, this is where I usually call stop DPS. They're coming in a few seconds. A lot of guilds can beat these, but I would recommend holding even if you can beat it. It makes the fight easier, okay? These next set of seeds are really simple. There's not much to talk about. They come out really late, so people have time to do their seeds, and then you have time to take it in. Look, spirits don't spawn till when, right? Still stop DPS, by the way. Spirits don't, and then you just do spirits normally. This is already in the last phase. And then the next two sets of spirits are the ones that you really need to talk about, okay? So first super hard set of spirits in the last phase is the very first one. The exact set of mechanics is you run away from the middle as soon as it spawns in 4 seconds. You're going to get seeds to spawn at the very end of the suck and spirits to spawn as well. These spirits, you go in immediately. You run against the wall, right? Run, run, run. If you have spirits on you right now, you go into the tear, into the tear, into the tear. You wait. As a raid leader, I'm calling wait to come back, wait to come back, wait to come back. Then you come back into the group and then you're good. Now, we had a few people die because this was like an alt run. But we just let, this is our lust. As you see, the fight time is 3 minutes. 2 minutes are up that you held from the previous phase, and 3 minutes are up. And this is where you rip a lust and just destroy the boss for one full minute with nothing happening. This is by far the best lust of the fight. I would not try to do it at any other point. It's where you'll have the most people alive and just every other reason for it. All right, so those are those spirits. So again, just to be completely clear on the spirits, and you can see, because I get it, you go through immediately as soon as the suck is over. You wait, you wait, you wait to bait your spirit, and then you go back. The reason you wait is your spirit will actually get to you and MC you if you come back too early. So, and then you get a lust right after it, right? All right, next set of spirits. This is a little bit easier. I don't get it on this set, so I can't really model it for you. but you just go in a little bit early. Let me wait till it's coming up. 10 seconds, 6 seconds. Here we go. Okay. Unleash power happens. Spirits is the first one on this, so there's nothing else happening. I recommend getting these and not going in immediately, but standing next to the tear and bait them over here. Remember we talked about before how you can bait them behind you, right? So if the boss is here and you're here, those spirits will always spawn here unless you face a different way and spawn them someone else, right? So spawn them somewhere else, right? Okay, so they're gonna spawn here just as you see in the video. You go like get close, but not go in right away. I AMS this because I have to do this seed set, and I'll talk about how to do this seed set later. Okay, and then you come back immediately, and then you get into the Windrush Totem there. And then the spirits are over before anything else happens. So that's the last set of spirits. All right, so now let's talk about seeds. I am going to go through the whole fight and show you how to do the really hard seed sets. But for now, I just want to tell you guys how to deal specifically with your seed that you have assigned to you. I'm going to tell you how we do seeds in general. We do square, triangle, skull, and X, assuming square is near the entrance. We do those every single time. We only do the diamond seed the first two times in the fight, okay? So the first set of, actually, so you don't do it sub 60% at all. The only reason you do it above 60% is because there's a hand of destruction or a glyph of destruction that needs to go over to the other side of the room, and it would kill the tank if you didn't move it, basically. Or you would take a ton of damage from the glyph, one of the two, okay? So we do, you can avoid the super hard diamond set later, which will really, really help you. All right, so classes. In general, Mage is the best class. Mage is so good at this fight, they could use half of their class utility and still do it better than every other class. Okay, so usually you assign mages to the hard seeds, like Square. Square's usually the hardest seed. Diamond's the hardest one, but you ignore it for half the fight, so it's not that big of a deal. A mage could do multiple things, right? As a mage, you have two Shimmers every time, you have Night Fae every other time, you have the Invis Conduit when you need it, and then you have Alter Time every other time at the beginning, but every time at the end. So a mage could do multiple things. For example, if you needed to run with the group, but you know you needed to pick up your seed after it, you could alter time on square, run to the raid, run against the wall. As soon as your alter time expires or the middle is over, you would alter time to your seed, double shimmer, drop, take the tear, be safe. Or let's say you just don't want to use alter time. Or obviously there's a variance to alter time, right? So you alter time on the boss, double blink to get your seed, Night Fae, run it to orange, alter time back, or take the tear. See, you're kind of getting the point, right? You don't even need half the things you have available to you. You can invis for a super huge movement speed if you're ever behind. And then worst comes to worse. Let's say a mage is late. He has the Night Fae over here. He has to double blink to pick it up. He forgot to alter time, so he runs it as far as he can, and then he can't make it to the tear, but then he has ice block, so who cares, right? There's no way you can mess it up as a mage if you make use of your whole toolkit. But that's generally the idea for mage. If you ever don't want to make a habit of using the tear, you can alter it every time. Alter isn't a bad idea because let's just say you have a Withering Touch, for example. You can like let yourself live because of an alter at the same time, right? So it just depends. You can also do something like this. Like if you want to make use of alter every time, you could alter here, blink all the way to square, and Night Fae to square, and then take the altar back, and then take the tear, drop it, take the tear back. There's a million ways, right? Mage, super easy. Druids, I usually assign druids to X and triangle for the first couple of hard seeds. Very simple, pick up the seed, use the super fast dash talent, 45 second cooldown one that makes you super quick at the beginning. I don't remember the name of it. You run straight into the star tear. If you have two moonkins, so let's say you have a moonkin here and a moonkin here, you guys would each Tiger Dash into the tear, port to the other side of the room, drop your seed, come right back, repeat, right? There is a better way to do it on the hard set, but I usually opt to sub out druids on the hard set. But if you have to do the hard set later, which I will show you on video, as a druid, during the knockback, you want to Tiger Dash across the room, drop it, and then take the tear. It's really hard to do, though. That's how you would do it as a druid, right? Okay, as a hunter, you just alternate Soul Shape what is it? The little tiger thing that makes you go super fast aspect of the cheetah. Obviously, you can disengage every time. If you were to do it on X and triangle, I think it's super easy because just alternating those, you could run it into the star tear and port, or you could just run it across the room the entire time. Hunter, turtle's your best friend. Turtle a bad ghost set. Turtle the one at the end that's really hard if you really need to. Like hunters on the super hard set where you get sucked into the middle, pulled out to the back, and then you're doing your seed after, you can either use all of your movement abilities, cheetah, soul shape, disengage, and you can do your seed during the suck-in. Or you can just wait till it's over, cheetah it into the tear, drop it, knowing you won't have enough time to come back, and just turtle. In my opinion, hunters, if you have turtle up on the super hard set in the last phase, I would wait until the suck is over, if you're on triangle X or skull, then pick it up, and then soul shape or cheetah into the tear, and then just turtle the seeds and then come back. That's my suggestion. Monks, same thing as before. This is a really good chi torpedo fight. You can have transcendence and 2 chi torpedoes every time. So let's just say you're a monk doing literally any seed. I mean, it's a total joke. Any seed, it's a joke. Let's say you're square, right? One of the harder seeds. Let's say you're even a windwalker monk. You're just in melee range hitting the boss, right? You transcend, pick up your seed, chi torpedo, drop it, take the tear, you're done. That's actually how you should deal with every single one. It would be a total joke. Yep, that's how you do it. Nothing else to say. Now, there is one hard set of seeds. It's the hardest set of seeds in the whole fight, and I'm going to show it to you now. Every other set of seeds besides this seed is pretty easy to manage, because it's generally speaking not during an annihilation. It's either all the way before it or directly after it. But it's not during it. This one is basically, it spawns right before it, so you have to do it during it, basically. This is where, on the raidplan.io, you can see I put DKs. Any spec of DK completely trivializes this wave. And I'll show you, because I will do it right in front of you. Okay? This seed, any other class has to use everything in their toolkit. DKs have AMS. Here, I'll back it up a little bit. DKs have AMS in case they get a ghost, which I do in this wave, by the way. I get a ghost right here, which is what I saved AMS for. I AMS my ghost. I'm hitting the boss. And as soon as you get sucked from the middle, you instantly death's advance next global, like you see me do right here. And then you just pick up your seed, walk it because you're not getting knocked back, drop it, and then port back. Right? Every other class in the game has to, like, go through hell and back to do that seed set correctly, and a DK can basically RP walk and do it. It's such a joke. So if you can, don't be mean to your Death Knights. Don't have them do that seed the whole fight because they're really slow and bad at it. But Death's advance on that particular wave is quite ridiculous. So I would take advantage of that. And keep in mind, in this exact VOD, notice that myself and Darky did the exact same thing. Because you can have a tank do it on this wave too, because there's not a glyph. So have tanks and DPS DKs do these 3 seeds on that wave if you have enough of them. So these 3. X, the one next to the tear, and triangle. And then you have stasis traps. Stasis traps, pretty simple. A lot of groups have 2 DKs. If you have 2 DKs, you can just alternate AMSing and IBFing. AMS, if you guys just alternate AMS, AMS can get every one. However, if you save your IBF till right before the hard seeds and IBF those 2 in a row, you can save your AMS for the spirit, as you'll see in the video I do later. You actually see that I will get the spirit and AMS it. So you want to have AMS for that so you can IBF those 2. So DKs are the god class for doing it. Who would have guessed? You can also turtle them, you can cloak them, you can bubble them. You can have a mage ice block and then grip them through stasis traps, but that's weird. Don't do that. Just... In all worst comes to worst, if I see a comment saying, hey, Max, my guild doesn't have any DKs, paladins, hunters, mages, or whatever else could clear that stuff, rogues. Well, I don't know. Just try to be stacked when they spawn and just have your tanks, just have one of your tanks, I'm not kidding, outside of Glyph of Destruction, just run into stasis traps and just cleave him down the whole fight. But if you do that, send me a video of it, though. 2 things are going to happen now. We're going to watch the video of my DK doing it and just kind of give you some general fight pointers that'll be edited down a bit. And then we're also going to show you a full-length video of a kill we had on this boss, which I believe is the slowest kill of it on Mythic. And it's just to show you that every single thing can go wrong and you can still kill it with proper raid leading and having to make it work a little bit. But the general gist of it, as you'll see, is it's just if you get past the hard wave, you can make it work. So let's watch through a little bit of this pull, starting from the hard part. You guys don't need to see above 80%. It's very easy. And a lot of these guides, I'm going in depth on what's actually hard. I'm not going to sit here and explain every tank mechanic and healer mechanic. you guys get it, right? Like, the boss, the main one is Withering Touch for healers, and then there's just general raid damage. All right, so from this point on, this is the one that people ask me the most. Why do you stop DPS? Why do you stop DPS? All right, two reasons. Number one, it's actually a little bit after this. It's after this first set of seeds. Right here. Okay, so do you guys see the timer planting seed in 23 seconds? Okay. If you push the boss anywhere around that timer, it will actually skip the seeds, but it will still do the ghosts. And I wish I could find a VOD where it actually happens. I think it'll happen in the extra video I show at the end of this, where when you push below 60, he's going to cast a new tear and get rid of the old ones, meaning you're going to have to kite the spirits without a tear, which is a nightmare. So that's why you stop. You can push it anytime after the spirits spawn. It's like the spirits are spawning like right now. So you can push it right now. I prefer to still wait until the spirit people come back just for optimal boss damage here. Right? But it's up to you. So like you see, we're already pushed in the next phase, but like the spirit people are kiting when you want to be doing boss damage. That's why you would wait just a few seconds longer. You just want to push after this wave because there's no reason not to. You're waiting. You're holding 2 minutes for lust. You know, you're going to lust at the 3 minute marker after you get done running away from the middle here and you get done doing the seeds and spirits, that there's no reason to have used anything earlier or to not wait, basically. Now, if you've done this and you're on farm, this video isn't for you anyway, and you can probably burn through it, but, you know, you do you if you're at that point. So this is the wave again to reiterate with spirits. You just wait and come back last possible second if you can. And this is the lust. Now, as a Death Knight, you saw that I armied on pull, and I even asked at the beginning of this video, hey, do you guys army at the on the pull, or do you wait for the last phase? If you're trying to kill this boss for the first time, there is no argument with this strat. You would not army on pull. You would not meta on pull. You would use all two and three minutes on pull, but not things that are longer than that, because they won't be up for the lust. Like, for example, I still get a use of army in the last phase, but it's not lusted, so it's clearly worse than me just holding army on the pull and saving it for lust. But I got two uses for overall damage, and this is farm, so we're just kind of doing whatever the fuck. Same thing with meta. If you're a DH and you meta on the pull and you get an extra use, but you don't get it in lust in the last phase, and it's kind of an easy boss and you're just vibing, that's fine. But for progression, if you want to know the purely optimal timings, it is absolutely more optimal to save meta and save army for this lust. Because you still only get one use in the last phase, right? It's just the difference of it being lusted or not. Now, this is the hardest part of the fight. I kid you not. If you guys just get that last little hard set of seeds out, you will kill it. Even with like five people dead, and as you will see in the video we play after this, you can do it with almost the whole raid dead, because the next two mechanic sets are an absolute joke. You get tricked because you never usually live long enough to see them, and the one you just did is unbelievably hard. But it's just the duality of the fact that they designed that last mechanic set you just saw, the second one under 60%, to be the hardest possible thing they could have designed. And then the one after it is the easiest possible thing they could have designed. And I believe we have two deaths, and this alt run is pretty low geared anyway. I didn't port for no reason, by the way. I ported to res him just before anyone is like, why the hell did you do that? Yeah, if you guys, I'm sure you guys are also familiar with your guilds where your warlock players and Moonkin players will never res people. So here we are. So this is how easy this set is. And I kid you not. Okay. Unleash power goes off. You get sucked into the middle for 12 seconds or 8 seconds or however long it is. And then spirits and seeds spawn after it's all over. So it's basically like you're doing P2. You run against the edge of the room, just like everyone else is doing here. Right. And then wait. Nothing spawned yet, and now seed spawn, and then now spirit spawn, right? There's no way anyone can do this. An LFR group could do these mechanics. That's how easy they are. So really, when you're talking about the argument of 4 healing versus 5 healing, what are you trying to beat? If you 4 heal and have enough damage, does it really matter if you beat the wave of mechanics you just saw? No. You run 5 healers because this withering touch dot that's dealing damage to pieces right now does this much damage, and it just destroys people, right? He was out of position, but you know, it kills people really easily. And then if you want to see the mechanic set after this, we won't see it in this video, and I hope you never have to see it. Oh, what I'm doing here, yeah, I knew we killed the boss, so I was just, never let the boss know you've won by not styling on him when you know you've killed him. So the double death's door there was for that. All right, so again, for a lot of people who just want to, this is going to be the end of the actual guide. So if you guys want to know anything more from me here, again, I'm trying not to make this as saturated as a lot of other guides are, where, you know, they're going to tell you what every mechanic does. What I'm trying to do is tell you exactly how to deal with it, where I feel like that's often missed, how to raid lead it, and then also just like little small things that I've learned from doing this boss a ton. We've probably done this as much or more than anyone, right? We do it in 4 groups every week. But yeah, that's the goal. Now, after this, I'm going to play you a full-length video of the worst Xy'mox kill I've ever seen, but still kind of impressive because, you know, we still did end up killing it, where I think a lot of people would have wiped, so I will let you listen to it with full comms, and I'll see you guys in the next video after we hit 60%, so like probably 20 seconds after that.
1 minute, please.
I wasn't calling you Ryan Dosu, I was calling Max Ryan. My bad, man.
What? I don't understand.
What's his name?
I'll get to his lip. At some undisclosed time.
Is that. Wait, do we need the FT gate? No, he's not.
Hello.
Here.
Hey!
Try to make sure they're always on the exact marker. Even if there's a stasis trap there. Do spirits. Good. Keep doing spirits, but the boss is already phasing. Take him to square ranged. Put your back so you're looking at X. Your back is facing the other side of square, so you actually spawn spirits behind you instead of where you're going. Except for seed people, you're on your own.
Okay, spawn in relation to you?
Behind you.
Kill the stasis trap now. Kill it now. Yeah, the spirits spawn behind you always. Okay, wait for the spirits to spawn before you guys move. Go now. Move now. Big movement, guys. You can't be late. Seeds are already blowing up. Spirits go in 3, 2, 1, go.
I'm seated on the other side.
You'll probably get ported back.
Wait, what?
I got you.
We probably have to res.
Kingfly probably, right?
Yeah.
Soaks.
Is that from, did your old spirit spawn in front of you? Or what
no,
actually
I
made you?
I had the gate.
Oh, the melee one is fucked there. Res Kingfly. These are also his soaks. Okay. Okay. So you don't need to bait anywhere. You guys can be by the tear. No. Please stop. Oh no. Okay. Please stop because it's okay. It already went phase 3. You might as well start now. But I think you guys are gonna lose your ghosts. You're gonna lose the tear for these ghosts. Get away from spirits or seeds. The tear's going away in 2 seconds. Take it instantly, or else you have to go on your own. And just hope you guys can kite it in time.
That's a bubble worth.
No way. Dude, this is fucking so bad. It's just the shaman totem for that. The roars are the next one. Spirits going insta. Going insta.
I did actually seed.
Okay, and seeds are blowing up soon. Wait. Then you lust here.
Did you X every time, Kingfly?
Yeah.
No, it should be lip. Here's so Padra should do the one that Dosu is doing, and lip should do the one on the tear. Kingfly should do the one on X. All you guys need to do is just have death advance as soon as you get sucked, and then
which
just do the seed
through?
During the timer.
Triangle.
It's triangle. Okay. Don't use your AMS here. You'll need it for ghosts. Do not AMS soak. We need like a. We can't even.
I got IVF.
Okay. Yeah, that's good. You guys can still do this down the people, because the wave after this is a joke and you'll kill it before the fourth. It's happening in 6 seconds. Go closer to the tear with the boss and everyone. This is you run closer to the tear. These stasis traps need to get soaked instantly. They're in 2 seconds. AMZ lit. Alright, good. Spirits soon, make sure you bait them. Spirits, you want to go in, wait till they're close to you, then go in. And then you want to run against it and then come right back. Okay. do these seeds, DKs. This is the hard set. Shit in the middle's over in 3, 2, 1. Live seeds, and you guys can still kill it. Live seeds. Go against the wall, guys. Go against the wall. Okay, this is your barrier twisted. Be in the barrier, guys.
Backup purple.
Glyph here. Be in the barrier for this. Kingfly AMZ in it as well. Huge damage here. Be in both. Hellstone if you have it. You guys are down one healer, so it's going to be a lot. We have 30 seconds to fill out the soaks. I'm just trying to get recovered here. All right, we're pretty good now.
We're resin 10.
Actually, just res Syrah.
I think you res Syrah to do the far one. All right, so we need a backup on... I can't see the marker, but... Blue. So who's doing square? Need someone to... Warlock's doing square. Kevin, is it you?
I can do it. Yeah,
okay,
I can do
so it. Kevin's doing square. Do we have X and Star or still Lip and Kingfly, right? Or X yep, and the Tear?
No.
Okay, so we need triangle, and then we're resing Syrah.
Triangle.
So, okay, we're good then. We're good. Then we'll deal. This set's a joke, by the way. It's a fucking joke. Like you do the entire.
Blue.
Who can do a blue?
Me.
Okay. You run against the wall first before you guys do anything. Watch the stasis traps. Get to. You have a speed totem, right?
Yeah.
Just don't get hit by the stasis trap if you can. Good. Vill, you're gonna rally as well. Middle, and then you do seeds now, and then spirits alone. Spirits, you want to go in insta spirits, and then wait until the seeds explode to come back. I'll call it. Come back in 3, 2, 1. Come back now. Good. Get out of the shit. Good. Big CDs to live here. Evade darkness under the boss. You want to use hellstones as well. Okay, so with this many people dead, we might actually even have to do the next set. But I honestly don't know what happens in the next set. I've never seen it before. Oh no. This is the one where seeds come out before everything else. So did we lose any seed soakers there? Any of them? Can everyone repeat the seed they just did?
Yep.
Okay, so what you guys do is in 27 seconds, you pre-position at your seeds, and the seeds, I believe this is from memory, I think they're the first thing that happens, so we can't lose anyone here as well. Maybe needs huge help. Good link, yeah. Okay, so tank explosion, 3 seconds. Drowny Devo, it might be too late. Good. Okay, you guys are at 8 seconds, pre-position at your seed now. Can we have any clear here? Congrats. Is there any clear up?
I got one.
Good, you're good. Guys, get to your seeds. They're the first thing that happens, I think.
Bill, get X.
Okay. Okay, just, yeah, the seeds are first thing. Get the seeds the fuck out immediately, and then we'll just YOLO the rest of it, okay? Okay, just get them away, and then run against the wall right now, I think. Yeah, run against the wall. We need a roar from any druid that's alive. Big throw.
Yeah, roll.
Good, now just do, after the seeds blow up, you just do spirits normal. Do spirits normal, and then we live. Huge healing on seed targets here. Do spirits normal. Nothing else is happening. Big throw might die. Hellstone, you have 2.
No, I'm sorry.
Cam Zonk. Okay, and then we don't soak stasis traps, and we just have to kill him in the next 45 seconds with who's alive. Is that possible?
I'm blasting.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a mythic plus boss.
It's a Legion or Argus.
You got, like, Evade and Maybe in there. Yeah, they're going to blast. You
just no, we might lose both healers to dots here, actually. Oh, my God. Maybe's alive, and his dot just got done.
I've convoked soon.
They should go boom.
Okay.
Boom box.
The next mechanics aren't for 20 seconds. This tank explosion is going to destroy us. Cams might die, actually. Yeah. And onk.
So you know there for a sec.
Just do not get hit by stasis traps, and you guys kill it in time. It's in 10 seconds. I think you guys have to ignore and just burn. There's no chance to do it.
Fatty Todd.
It's a mythic plus boss.
This fight owns on farm.
Okay, the mechanics are happening now. I'm going to be honest with you. I have no fucking clue what order it goes in, but...
This is the Argus non-elite mob.
Seeds are first, but should it matter? You have 15 seconds to kill it.
Todd.
Here comes the Todd.
Let's go, baby. DPS. Let's go.
This is so easy.
Come on. Oh my god, dude. Oh my god.
Lip, you're fucking crazy.
So that was it. So hope you guys enjoyed that. I like these videos to include showing me raid leading it, especially when a lot of stuff goes wrong, so you can see the improvisation and exactly what you should do. And also just, you know, how to do every mechanic. I feel like not every guide goes how to do it for every class, so... make sure you guys like and subscribe if you guys enjoyed the video, and there will be a few more of these over the next few days. So, see you guys later.